Have you ever seen an aircraft trying to climb again when it seemed like it was about to land? An aircraft that has reached the landing phase in this way gives up landing and reclimbs. We call this go-around. There are many reasons why pilots do go-around. First, the most representative factor is that the runway or approach light system is not visible until just before landing, or that there may be weather factors such as a severe crosswind. In addition, there are some unpredictable factors such as aircraft instability, confrontation with a flock of birds, failure of the controller's separation, and runway incursion. But go-around isn't just for pilots. The controller also instructs the pilot to go around to prevent landing if it detects a risk factor that makes it impossible to land. If the aircraft fails to land, it would be best if it could land again using the shortest distance, but it takes more time than expected. This is to rearrange the landing sequence with the following aircraft, but the main reason is to re-perform the instrument approach procedure. Wondering what this means? In the landing phase, the aircraft approaching the airport has a specific route that allows to receive the most stable radio waves from the ground and simultaneously to make a flight in the safest, obstacle-free way. We call this an instrument approach procedure. That is, the approach procedure is required without exception, even for aircrafts that have attempted go-around. Although it takes time, since this procedure is the safest, after the go-around, the pilot should follow the approach procedure and re-approach. Instrument approach procedures are divided into initial, intermediate, final, and missed approaches. Here, missed approach means the stage of ascending again after failing to land, and the controller and pilot sometimes use the term missed approach instead of go-around when the instrument flying aircraft makes a go-around. So wait, do go-around and missed approach have the same meaning? According to the FAA, go-around refers to an instruction to abandon landing-related approaches. In the case of VFR aircraft, after go-around, you follow the controller's instructions or climb over the runway to the pattern altitude to enter the crosswind. In the case of an IFR aircraft and instrument approach, go-around means that the published missed approach procedure should be performed, or the controller's instruction should be followed. In other words, the term go-around is used to convey non-landing to all aircraft regardless of flight rule. And missed approach is a term used when an aircraft performing an instrument approach must fly a missed approach segment. Then you may be concerned about what happens if the aircraft you're on made a go-around and runs out of fuel. But you don't have to worry about this. The aircraft flies with enough fuel to be able to divert to another airport after multiple reapproaches, as well as emergency fuel for the second and third reapproaches. Not only pilots and controllers, but also airlines do not prefer go-around that cause economic losses such as fuel consumption and delays. But go-around is the surest and safest means at the last moment. There is no need to panic if your aircraft is going around. Airplanes with enough fuel, safety-first pilots, and controllers to keep you safe are working hard behind you. ATC for you.